For this year of mercy, there's an old saying in the church that you can't give what you don't have. And so all of us will understand more tangibly, more personally, the amount of mercy that we've received, and hopefully exemplify some gratitude. You know, gratitude is almost a key element of receiving mercy. We're not necessarily always attuned to that very well unless we're contemplating that ultimate mercy of Christ. So the question is, how do we then put in place this mercy for others that we're called to as Catholics and as Christians? And there's two components really in the history of the church, the spiritual works of mercy, as well as corporal works of mercy, the more physical works of mercy. For example, giving food to the hungry, drink to the thirsty, and clothing the naked. Through the great work done by the Catholic Multicultural Center or through Catholic Charities, through their mobile food pantries, the church has these programs in place that are very well done, very efficient, and very hospitable to people.
I think camp has a really great way to share the year of mercy with youth. St. Thomas Aquinas says that love is to will the good of the other. And in talking about that with kids and sharing that, you can get to a new place in understanding your mercy and by showing love to each other.
I love teaching at Catholic school. It's a family. Like, your school is a family. We're not just one grade. They know the younger kids. They're interacting, they're talking, they're taking care of each other. When everything's taught in the lens of Christ loves you deeply, it changes everything. It makes you want to work hard. It makes you want to treat people with dignity. It makes you know that there's a purpose and it's more than just getting an A.
This year of mercy that Pope Francis has started in the church, we can give renewed attention to counseling the doubtful and comforting the afflicted.
People who come to Project Rachel often have doubts about accepting God's forgiveness. Sometimes they don't know what they are looking for, and we let them talk, we listen to them. We're there to be a companion to them on their journey.
A necessary part to grow in virtue is to admonish them when they do something wrong, to admonish the sinner. It can be done very charitably, very lovingly, and that is what the church does with all of our children, is to admonish them to not only avoid sin, but also to grow in virtue, which in mercy is one of the great virtues. I sincerely invite them to come back to the sacrament of confession if they've been away for a while. It can seem a little difficult, a little humbling, a little traumatic to confess your sins, but in doing that, you unload so much, and you come out of that confession being renewed.
When I thought about becoming a priest, the initial thought was to serve the church in a different country, but I didn't have any particular country in mind. I never even knew that there was a place called Madison or Waunakee. I mean, if you hear about America, pretty much you know of Chicago, New York, but people really wanted to take me in and get to know more about myself, my culture, my background. There was not even a single moment where I felt lonely and just been made to feel part of the family. So that has been really a blessing to me and a blessing to my adjustment to the new culture and the new life in America.
We welcome the stranger, whether from across the world or from within our borders. We want to make it as inviting as possible for people to feel the healing mercy of God's grace.
I've certainly experienced a lot of God's mercy. In my own life, I would certainly say, I mean, probably the most recent and biggest way that I've experienced mercy was just in the healing that I've received through my battle with cancer. So I really saw the power of prayer. And truth be told, it wasn't always my prayer. In fact, very seldom was it my prayer, but it was everybody else's prayer. But I think in battling cancer and seeing the mercy shown from so many people, from people that I knew very well to people that I'd never met, I think was an amazing testament to me to the power of faith. I really could just feel the love of those around me and the love of the church kind of just surrounding me.
There is never a lack of need for these important works of mercy. Over the past few years, a number of my brother priests and I have increasingly been ministering to the imprisoned in our diocese. Two of the inmates there both wanted to pull me aside and say, "I've learned more about my Catholicism here than I ever did before." they've really developed a certain Catholic culture among those who are attending that chapel. In this regard, forgiving offenses is kind of like that courage or bravery of battle, right? To be able to forgive completely from the heart is somewhat Herculean, but with God's grace can be done. You know, to forgive offenses is kind of the higher level, but to bear wrongs patiently over time is like that perseverance. It just has to go on day by day. I'll bet St. Maria Goretti, besides that heroic virtue of forgiving her killer, and the days leading up to that, bared wrongs patiently. That's why St. Maria Goretti is such a great model, because she did this all in the early teenage years. And if she can do it, you know it's got to be by God's grace that someone that young can do it. And that's what we're asking in the Year of Mercy from our Lord.
Dear friends, it's that time of year again when we initiate the annual Catholic Appeal in the Diocese of Madison. We've just come through a very successful capital fund drive. I know that, and so I don't come to you again with this request lightly. And yet you were so wonderful last year. It's a testament to your generosity, your goodness, your prayerfulness, your receptivity to the grace of Jesus Christ. So let me ask you to do the best you can again this year, so that together, through the spiritual works of mercy and through the corporal works of mercy, our whole diocese will continue to grow in holiness and to grow as a living expression of the mercy of the Lord during this wonderful year of mercy. Thank you very much for listening to me. God bless you, and praised be Jesus Christ.